Hello students, we have seen orthography projections so far. Today is going to be the last practice sheet on orthography projections. We have solved different problems and now we are in a position to view the objects from different directions and we can now draw their front view, top view, side view, etc. Based on the direction of viewing and today we will be seeing the last of such assignment. So again there is one object shown. Now this is a question and the answers are what you are going to draw. The answers are not readily available. So you will be solving this question and drawing the different views. I am just going to explain to you what could be the surfaces that are seen in which view. So in this case you can see this is the direction of viewing, so that this becomes your front view. So when you see in this direction, what are going to be the surfaces which you are going to see? That is the first thing. So as you can see here, this front surface which is there, that surface is visible, and incidentally the dimensions of this and this are same. Therefore this similar shape which is there, that is exactly going to be behind this object, so that you don't have to draw this again. When you draw this, automatically this will be getting covered. So you start the object from, let us say, this corner, maybe from this corner. So you go here, then go up. This is the front shape, and on this side, what are you going to do, up to what you are going to draw, and what is the shape of this particular surface? So as you have already seen such similar thing earlier, the curvature starts from this point and it is a semicircle. So for us, we are going to see only the quarter circle, and that too, when you are looking in this direction, it will not be realized as a circular shape, because this is in continuity, there is no change of surface, there is no line here. Therefore, for us, this is going to be just a rectangle. The size of the rectangle will come up to, now here what they have done is, they have shown the dimensions. As you can see here, 130, 130 is the dimension from this corner. See at what level they are taking. It is taken at the base level. So from this corner to this corner, and what is this corner? This corner is nothing but the center of this circle. So the center of the circle is at 130 distance from here. And from the same center, this outside curvature is drawn. The size of that is R40. That means after this point, you are going to go ahead in this direction by another 40. That means from this end to this end, the size is going to be 130 plus 40, that is 170. So when you draw, this is going to be a shape that will be coming in this left direction, just as a rectangle, which will go up to another 40 beyond 130 to make it 170. So that becomes your front view when you draw like this. Then you have to also draw this kind of a curvature, which is a semicircle. The center of the semicircle is at a height of 20. And after you draw this 20, then you have to draw this semicircle. Now what else you are going to see and what else you are supposed to draw? Now as you see here, there is one hole. The size of the hole is diameter 40, and then it is a through hole. So you are going to draw two dotted lines on either side of the center line here. So first you have to draw the center line at this place, and that center line is going to extend beyond the object. Center line is going to extend beyond the object. So as you can see here, the center lines are also drawn for the semicircle, which are drawn beyond the semicircle, slightly more than semicircle. So like that, for this particular hole, you are going to draw one center line which is having a length beyond 20, say 2-3 mm above 20, 2-3 mm below 20. And then you are going to draw two dotted lines corresponding to the size 40. So on either side of the center line, 20 in this direction and 20 in this direction, there are going to be two dotted lines you are going to draw on either side of the center line to represent this hole. Now any other thing which is also there, you can see there is a triangular rib here. The dimension of the rib is given 25 by 25. Vertically not given, but you can assume it is 25. Or maybe you can work it out from 100. From 100, if you subtract say 48 and 20. So whatever it comes, probably it may not come 40. It might come more, 27 perhaps. So whatever the dimension of the triangle, that triangle will be fitting here in your front view. And you are going to draw this line also, because this surface and this surface are different. So you will be able to draw this line and then a diagonal line to represent the triangle, which is a rib. So that will complete the front view. Now after front view, let us try to see from above. So when you see from above down, what are the different things you are going to see? Now one thing is, this top view will show you the overall shape of the object, which is from this corner to this corner, that is one dimension, which is equal to how much? That is equal to, as you can see here, R40. That means this side is 40, this side is 40. That means the width is 80. So when this width is 80, this also is going to be 80 here, because as you see here, it is parallel. So from here to here it is 80. Out of that, this is 40. So the remaining 40 will be divided 20 and 20 on other side. So 20, then 40, then 20. So when you are going to draw, you are going to draw this continuous line of length 80. Although here the actual line is like this, then it goes down, then like that, then comes up, and then it is like this. For us, it is going to be a straight line of length 80 on one side. Then on the other side, you are again going to draw this line and all these lines up to here. Up to here. They are drawn as a straight line. So you are going to draw a line from this end to the center of the circle as a line of length 130, which will cover all these different things. So you are going to draw 80 by 130, 80 by 130 on this side also, again 130. So 130, 80, 130, that is the shape you are going to draw, and then this end you are going to cover by this semicircle. The size of the semicircle is 40 radius. So that is the overall shape of the figure. And then in this shape, you are going to draw one circle of diameter 40 at this place. The position is 130 from here. So on the base of size 170 by 80, 80 here and 170 here, the one thing that will come is circle over here, semicircle over here. Now for this particular shape, you are going to draw only this rectangle. This inclined rectangle will be seen as a rectangle of size 25 by 10. It will come just as a rectangle of size 25 by 10 as its projection. Then you have to draw these two things. For drawing these two things, you will be drawing one more line here. So all these things will come as a one line. This entire surface will be drawn as a single line. Similarly, the backside of this surface, which is again a line. So in this rectangle, you are going to draw two lines at a distance of 20 from here and 20 from here to represent these two plates. And at the same time, you are also going to draw these two lines here as per the dimensions given here. So that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and this 7, all these surfaces will be visible from top when you see. Now any other thing you are supposed to show here, see there is a hole here, semicircular hole. So there will be two edges, one edge here and one edge here. So these two edges are there right from one end to another. So you are going to draw two dotted lines from this point to the back, from this point to the back. And where is this point? This point is at center distance. The distance is R24 from this point, center. And where the center? Center is at the middle of this. So since this is 80, that means this is 40. So at a distance of 40, you get the center. And then from center on either side, you are going 24 and 24. And then you are going to get these edges, which you are going to draw as dotted lines. So maybe they might come somewhere in between these two rectangles. But then you have to draw from one end to another of length full 80 here. So that becomes your top view. Now let's go and draw the left hand side view drawn on the right side. So what you will see in this direction. So when you see in this direction about this plate, which is having a semicircle, you will be drawing that as a rectangle. The dimension of the rectangle is 80 like this and 20 like this. So you draw a rectangle of size 80 and height is 20. Then in that rectangle, we are going to show two dotted lines to represent this hole, and the distance is from the center line, it is 40 and 40. So two dotted lines you will draw vertical. You will of course draw the center line also, which is extended beyond the thickness 20. Then above this plate, you are going to draw this rectangle. This inclined surface will be seen as a rectangle whose height is going to be this much and the width is going to be 10. So you are drawn one vertical rectangle. Then after that, you are going to see this surface. This C-like shape which is there, this surface you will draw. And in the same surface, this rectangle will come. So on this rectangle, on either side, there is the remaining part of C. The shape is like this, like this, like this, like this, like this, this. So that is the shape, all the dimensions are there, so that you can draw this shape. What else is there? Now you can see there is one cutout here. Okay, if you draw just like this, that means this is solid. But in actual practice, this is not solid, this is a cutout here. So one surface is created here. So this surface is at a depth of 20. So here, at a height of, at a depth from here, 20 depth, here you will draw one dotted line, and here also you will draw another dotted line to represent these two surfaces, which are not directly seen, they are hidden. But we are going to draw them to represent them by dotted lines. Similarly, there is a curvature here, there is a cutout here. So at this particular highest point on the semicircle, which is at a distance of 20 plus 24, so 44 from the base. So 44 from the base, you are going to draw one line which will go like this. From here to here. So that is the left hand side view, and that completes all the three views for this object. Okay, so now there is one more problem. This is another problem for today's exercise. Again, some object is given, dimensions are there, and this is going to be the direction of viewing the figure, that is the front view, in this direction. So now let us again do the same thing. Try to imagine how the object is made up of, and then we draw the different views by proper imagination. So as you see here, when you see in this direction, this L shape will be clearly visible, the dimensions are there. So you will draw this L shape first to start with. Then here behind there is one surface. Now this surface is there, but it is not seen. So vertical like this, at a distance which is say 10 mm written here. So at a distance of 10 mm, you will draw one dotted line to represent this surface which is not seen. Then moreover, you can see there is one cutout here. So there are corners here and here. So these corners or edges which are there at a height of 14 from the base. So you will draw one more dotted line like this. So now this dotted line will represent this corner or this corner. Then next thing is, you have to just check what are the dimensions here. See, the height is 20, height is 14. And here the size you can see is 28. So radius is 14. That means this also is 14. That means this lowest point is same as this level. Lowest point and this lowest point, they are at same level. So there will not be any additional line which will come for this shape. Now on the upper side, there is a height. This height is 14. Then after 14, there is 28. So at a distance of 28, you get the center. And after 28, since the width is 28, you are going to draw 14 and 14. So 14 is the height. So this object will be going up to a maximum height of 14. So that is the total height, 14 plus, I think this is not 20, it is 20. So 14 plus 20 plus 14, that becomes the height. So at that place, you will be drawing one more line like this. Now in actual practice, this is there is a curvature here, so this line is slightly below the highest point. But that we will ignore at the moment, and we will just draw this line at the height of this semicircle. And then from this point to this point, we are going to draw this inclined line to represent this triangular rib. This triangular rib will be shown by joining this point to this. Then another thing is, you can see here there is one elliptical hole. This is an elliptical hole, and its dimensions are again, center to center dimensions are 20, and then the curvature semicircle has got a size 14 as the width. So it is a radius 7. So go up by 7 and go down by 7 from the center lines. So the total height of this hole is 20 and 7 and 7. So 7 and 7, 14 plus 20. So 34 is the total height. So at whichever is the place, at that point you are going to draw two dotted lines to represent these two extreme ends of this elliptical slot. So that will complete the front view in this direction. So you will see this surface, you will see dotted line here. For this corner, you will see dotted line here. Then for the height, at this height, you will have one line. And then you have this inclined line for representing the rib. And then two dotted lines to represent this elliptical hole. So that becomes the front view. Now the top view. So look at the drawing from above. Look at the object from above. And then see what you are going to see which shape. So the first thing is, this C shape will be clearly seen. Now this C shape has got the dimensions which are like this. So these dimensions you can make use of and draw this shape. Then there is another shape which is this. This whole shape will be seen just as a straight line, and then this whole thing as a straight line. So whatever is the total size here, 38, 30 plus 18. In fact, here this is also 18. So 18, 30, 30, 18. That becomes the total length here. So you just draw a straight line to represent all these various shapes. Then you will draw this rib at a distance of 10 mm thickness at a suitable place, which is a midpoint. So draw these two lines to represent the rib, and maybe draw other two lines, this and the back side, at a distance of 28. So 14 and 14 on either side. You draw this line and the back line. Then any other line is remaining. There will be two dotted lines for representing this hole at a distance of 14. So 7 and 7 on either side of center line. Two dotted lines will come to represent this hole. Similarly, there will be two more lines come as dotted lines to represent this hole. So there will be dotted lines for this corner, dotted lines for this, dark lines for this, and dark lines for this rib. And the C shape, that becomes a description of the top view when you draw. Then comes the right hand side view. So what do you see in this direction? Looking in this direction, what are the different shapes you are going to see? So first thing is this O shape, and then these two sides. So whatever shape you see here, this whole shape you have to draw, and then the hole as per whatever dimensions are shown. So that is one surface you see. Then above this surface, you are going to see this triangle, triangular surface, but as a rectangle of size 10 mm wide and whatever is the height. Same thing, this background surface is there. This background surface will be seen as a rectangle. This height and this width. And then up to that height, whatever is there, 50, you will join this point to this highest point to represent this triangle, which is a rib. And once you draw this, then any other thing that is remaining you have to draw. So you can see there are two edges here. So these corners or edges which are there, they will have to be drawn as dotted lines. So two dotted lines will come, one here and one here. These two dotted lines will represent these edges. So that becomes a right hand side view drawn on the left hand side. So we have seen all the shapes, the front view, the top view, the right hand side view. And you can draw them without any difficulty because we already performed a lot of exercises. Remember one thing, questions are not to be drawn. So this is a question. So you don't have to draw this. Only you have to draw the three views. They are called as the orthographic views. So only the orthographic view you have to draw, and you don't have to draw the question. This question is in fact drawn in three dimensions. This is called as isometric drawing. We are going to learn how to draw the isometric drawings during some other lecture time. That time you will come to know how this is drawn. Right now you don't draw this as a question. Only solve the problems and draw the orthographic projections.